buildings and structures within the Gardens Centre site, and replacement buildings including the expansion of coffee shop and restaurant areas, the expansion of the aquatic centre, new circulation routes and canopies within the site, landscaping and the provision of overstore car parking. As a redevelopment proposal, and the principle of numbers is established that a local rental certificate for the use of the site was granted in 2012, which would cover the application area. The proposals would actually decrease the amount of retail floor space within the site. It is indicated in support of the application that the retail uses could not be disaggregated from the garden centre offer to locate into town centres. Given this, it's not considered that there is conflict with retail policy. The redevelopment would not harm openness to rebuild the reduction in floor space. The redevelopment is considered to allow job retention in its rural location and support economic growth. The new building proposals will allow removal of unsightly buildings and open the courtyard complex, which contains attractive sandstone buildings which form part of the original bar on the site. In conclusion, it's recommended for approval, subject to conditions to secure details of surface water drainage, samples of materials, and details of landscaping works, restrict the nature of the retail use at the site and come to range with a range of goods that can be sold on that. And so the recommendation is also subject to referrals from the Secretary of State, and given that it's a major departure in the green belt.
Thank you, Matthew. David, and who else?
Just a very quick comment. Chair. As far as I'm concerned, I live local. It is a long overdue proposal. I'm delighted support it.
I think he's beat me to it. Yes, I often travel down there. I even go into this area. It's a hodgepodge. At present moment, it's had economic increase. I'd like to have all acceptance of it.
Jeff?
Yeah, well, I agree. This is obviously a sensible proposal, which is tied in, which is currently a mess. But I noticed that a long planning history through some local developments. I just wonder whether the officer would be able to comment on how we get to the situation where you get such a large commercial development in the Greenbelt actually grows up. I'm thinking of another one outside our borough, which I thought was going to move exactly in by 40. But what's the town is growing like that and nothing?
And there is a long site history on this site. It has grown over the years and to temporary buildings which have become more permanent. And the bottom line is that there haven't been complaints about the operation of the site, and that in tools the operator of the site has sought to regularise the situation by submitting local rental certificate. We are where we are. The current proposal proposes a refurbishment and remodelling of that site.
Good answer, but
one quick point I failed to mention. There was an issue over the washing of cars on the premises, and that was subject, I think, originally to some enforcement proceedings. Can you comment on where that is up to and what is intended in terms of pursuing that, or is it not intended to pursue it?
I'm not 100% sure, and I'll get back to you if that's okay. I understand that the enforcement case is still open, although elements that were subject to that case have been removed, so buildings, for example, there was a small hut there, I think, which has gone down. But I understand the case is still on, and I'll come back to you before answer.
Are you happy with that, David? Okay. Stuart?
Can I ask, is there any proposal to demolish the sandstone buildings? Is it the state of buildings that are not demolished?
In my understanding, it's been retained. Some cluster on the left hand side of the site is to be retained and used in a complex of ancillary uses at the site.
Such a popular proposal, we've got a long question. It's up for approval. Well, Denise was signaled to propose, so Denise, I'm going to have Eddie in a second, if that's all right, if you don't. Okay.
Yeah.
So, can we put that to the vote? All those in favour? And that's unanimous. So that's been approved. Thank you very much. The Bonanza Site Business Centre, we've got to number 10, which is Safe Harbour, near St. Helens, 1 Abbott's Drive in Bevington, a visit this week, so we've had a chance to look at. So can we just have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Through you, Chair. Similarly to the Tupasi Young Care Home that we just considered, the site is within a primarily residential area. As such, it's acceptable in principle subject to UDP policy HS8. The key issues are really whether the proposal relates well to existing properties, whether it generates amenity issues from the built forms itself or car parking and the movements associated with it. Considering the scale, the proposal is two-storey. It has a lower ridge height than the main buildings, the existing buildings within the site. The scale of the proposal has been reduced following the refusal of permission of a larger scheme in 2012. Whilst it is close to the boundaries with neighbouring properties, particularly Anne Scott to the northeast of the site and the garden on 37 Heath Road, each of these properties does have a long rear garden. That ensures that there's ample separation distance to the properties themselves. The issue is whether there is an overbearing impact, considering that the scale of development in relation to the existing nursing home is not considered that total barriers would warrant refusal of the scheme. No habitable windows are proposed facing those neighbouring properties. The main outlook would be within the courtyard to the rear of the nursing home. In terms of car parking, the proposal would reduce the extent of car parking by two spaces, and additional spaces are proposed, but overall would be a net loss of two. The level is considered to be appropriate for a care facility this kind. There is on-street parking available, which is considered can be safely accomplished without harm to residential amenity or to highway safety. It's recommended for approval, subject to conditions to ensure that the small windows proposed towards the main properties of school are laid in the town.
Ms. Councillor Woodsey, please.
Just a very quick comment. Another situation where a visit to the site was very valuable because it showed the whole thing in context and indicated clearly what the implications might be for adjacent properties. As the officer has said, the other properties are so far away I can't see there being any amenity value issues, particularly as there's massive boundary treatment in terms of trees that would prevent any site of the development from those residential properties that have registered some concern. In fact, I think there's only one person that's objected, and they've objected to reduction of light, it would have a dominant impact on the dwelling of the foxes, and construction will be difficult. Well, having spent 40 years in the construction industry, yes, construction might be difficult, but that's not a planning issue. The other point that's worth noting, I think, on the bottom of page 61, the bottom paragraph, which makes it clear that the current application is an amendment to a previously refused scheme, and the changes take those reasons for refusal into account. So on the basis of that, having seen the site and considered what is actually there, I'm quite happy to approve the application, Chair.
Thank you, Dave. When we went to the site visit, there was a couple of neighbour disputes that were going on, and they've been referred to the landlords, I think. So that has got nothing to do with planning. They're not planning issues, but the people who were there with problems, I think, have been referred on. But as I say, they were not anything to do with planning issues at all. So if there's no further questions for anybody, can I have a proposer and a seconder, please? Dave, thank you, and a seconder, thank you, Anita. So all those in favour, please show. And against, and one abstention. No abstention, thank you very much. So that's been approved. Number 11 is the cottage, Rest Hill Road, Peter's Daughter. Okay, so that's alterations and extension to an existing cottage. External way. So can we have the presentation, please, Matthew?
Thank you, Chair. Through you, Chair. The application is an alternative to a scheme that was approved in 2012 at the site. It does include additional floor space that's approved previously. That additional floor space must be considered against Greenbelt policy. Policy GB5 seeks to ensure that extensions to residential properties do not result in disproportionate additions to the original dwelling house. The policy itself sets out a 50% threshold, so increases should not exceed that limit. In practice, however, consideration does need to be given to the current characteristics of the site to be itself. In this case, the enlargement permitted in 2012 was a 64% increase in floor space. The alterations undertaken at the site are actually slightly larger than that. They result in a 69% increase. However, that calculation is not considered to result in development is inappropriate in its context or harmful to the opening of the greenbelt. Policy on rebuild extension must also be considered bearing in mind increased community development allowances in recent years. Since 2008, community development allowances have allowed further extensions to properties than previously. Significant extensions to houses and immigration are those that take place in this development regulations. In this context, whilst the original policy has been enlarged, it's not considered that it would be detrimental to progress or character. The choice of materials undertaken is to apply the policy HS11 and the National Planning Policy Framework is recommended for review. The previous scheme did propose a net gain of 14 spaces, so 14 would propose with the
previous. So, in the balance, we would then be buying more backlog?
Chair, thank you. Can you just indicate for us where the access would be? I gather it's off Wharf Street, but just for clarification for the members of the audience who might have read. There was by the W of Wharf on the indicative plan. Thank you very much.
Steve?
Yeah, I think, normally very well in my employment, not usually the land somewhere, interest. It really is important, the design, and reassured by the comments from the English Heritage about the design. And it has been possible on the village to build new properties that blend in some cases, almost indistinguishable from the older buildings, as other than the fact that they were weathered into. So I'm glad that the design has been closely looked at. Parking is an issue, right? I still think. Lots of the people associated with the industry around that still do try and park on the village. So whilst my main concern is more design, I think we should try and be as strict as we can in the future about buildings and parking spaces. But I welcome the fact that affordable rents will be available as such a crucial part of our work that people deserve to live in this role. So we balance that.
I'd like to echo Steve's comments. No, I absolutely welcome no boxes and no followers. I think there's a test that we need to look for this type of boxing.
I don't know whether it's possible for the officers to make sure that we don't have any new development on in this area that we have parking in relation to parking.
Just to confirm that each application would have to be considered on its individual merits. Yeah.
Thank you. That was just Is there any other comments? No? Okay, so the recommendation is to approve. Can I have a move in second, please? Thank you, Steve and Leo Stewart. All those in favour? Thank you very much. Agenda item 13 is the water waste pumping stations, land off Town Lane West. Can we just have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Through Chair, the scheme is the development is part of a larger scheme for improvement of water quality that's been brought forward by a partnership with the Environment Agency, United Utilities, and Ofwat. The main part of the work, which is the construction of a new pumping station, is permitted development. It's only the control kiosk and fencing required as part of that development is seeking validation for. The existing pumping building to the west is in need of significant repair, subject to frequent flooding, and hence the partnership organisation is looking to replace it. The site of the new pumping station is considered to be less significant in terms of its greenbelt location. It's further out of the open area of the greenbelt and to the west. In terms of the sequentially available sites, the partner organisations have put quite clear a bit where a pumping station could go and dismissed other opportunities. We consider this amount to a very special circumstance of justifying the rebound development in this instance, so it's recommended for approval subject to conditions which would then require surveys of Japanese knotweed and low-crested new mitigation measures within the site.
Okay, questions? Mover, seconder, please. Thank you, David and Wendy. All those in favour? Thank you. Number 14, Heswell Squash Club in Brimstitch Road. Okay, this is development of the extension of an existing building occupied by the Heswell Squash. Chester Road. Access to Brooms Digital on Chester Road. Sorry, we get our locations exactly right. Can we have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Through you, Chair. The proposals for extensions comprising a new sports hall, gym facilities, and changing rooms. And
ancillary cafe and the realignment of car parking inside. The key issue really is that the application site is within the green belt. It proposes a leisure use in and out of the centre location. These, along with the proposed design, in this case, a number of justifications have been set out in support of development in this location. Firstly, the benefits of the proposal to community sport and leisure, enhancing the offer already at the site and within adjoining football club and playing field facilities to create a sports hall and sports facilities. Secondly, supporting info information sets out a sequential argument in favour of the site as opposed to more central ones within the natural area. Thirdly, a poor state of repair of existing an economically viable solution is set out there. And lastly, the identified needs and opportunities for sport have been set out by applicants and partnerships with education and sports sports in local area. In combination, these factors are considered to be a compelling argument presenting very special circumstances necessary to support the appropriate development of Greenbelt and to support leisure in the central location. Considering the design of the development, the existing building is undistinguished. The proposal represents an opportunity to secure high quality redevelopment. Performance and scale of developments is acceptable, but there's also no significant impact to the residential properties, which are south of Chester Road and 38 metres away. Overall, the proposal is considered to constitute a sustainable development in an accessible location. It's recommended for approval, subject to conditions, to confirm the details of materials, landscaping, levels within the site, the hours of use of the premises, and to restrict the use of the use capacity to leisure use. Lastly, a condition is imposed to secure tinted glass on the southeast elevation to prevent light pollution on that side of the building. The application was also referred to the Secretary of State, given it is a green light.
Just before we go anyway, can you just please explain what the Secretary of State is here with the rest of the committee, please?
Through you, Chair, there's a 2009 directive. Which requires a certain applications of a certain scale to be referred to the Secretary of State before the Council can issue its final decision. It's akin, really, if you like, to the former arrangements that we used to have where we used to refer to the Government Office. Because the additional floor space on this is just over 1,000 square metres, it falls outside of the parameters, so because it's Greenbelt, it will need to be referred to the Secretary of State just to make sure that they don't have to pull it in.
David?
Just a very quick comment. It's interesting to know this is an enhancement of a well-used and well-level facility. It has not that I use, I know what people do. And it's also interesting to note that the only objection we have received is from somebody living in Dunster Grove across from there, which in fact wasn't built at those houses at the time the Racket Club was introduced. So it's interesting idea that they feel able to comment on something that wasn't around when that house was built, bearing in mind Racket Club's been there a long time. So I would be happy to propose approval for this application.
Okay, well, we've got a proposed.
Oh, sorry.
No, the next one. I'm sure they would have let us know if you wanted to speak, I'm sure. Okay, so it's been proposed by David, it's been seconded by Denise. All those in favour, please show. Thank you very much. That proposition has been approved. Thank you. The co-op food store in Cranberry Road, the installation of a new ATM and shop fruit section. Can we have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Through you, the proposal is for the installation of an ATM at the front elevation of the existing co-op on Cranberry Road. The development also includes a single bar which will be installed to protect the ATM and a section of shop frontage that would need to be altered to accommodate the structure surrounding the ATM with overpaid glass. In terms of the principle, it's a primarily residential area, but this is an established non-residential use. UDP policy HS15 is the relevant policy. In terms of issues, the key concerns raised in representations are the potential for nuisance to adjoining properties through additional traffic and parking, through noise, through illumination, and through out-of-hours activity. So there's knowledge that there may be additional vehicle movements to the site resulting from development. given the nature of